Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, ma'am.
So previous day, I taught you regarding making of a socialist society, and that I told that a few policies what the Bolsheviks introduced in the country, and as a part of that, they started setting targets, and 5-year plans were started. Now, as a part of 5-year plans, we can see they introduced centralized planning. Then mainly the industrial production, it went very high. So these were the few points which we discussed in the previous class. Other than that, before they told some policies that when they will come to power, they will introduce some policies. I told you, what were those policies? Some 2-3 points, yeah.
They will nationalize the bank.
Yes, they nationalized the banks and industries. Another one important thing.
Permitted
the peasants to control the or seize the lands, and they can start doing cultivation. And one more thing, what they did, Bolsheviks themselves, they seized or confiscated some of the lands, and they showed the people how to do the cooperative cultivation or cooperative communism. As a part of that, they made communes. I mean, in the sense, large areas of land were confiscated, and there the people, they were doing the cultivation on a cooperative basis. The land, everyone will work on the land, everyone will have same type of facilities, everyone will have same way of living, dwellings and all, and whatever profit they are getting, that will be shared among everyone. So this system was there in Russia in the beginning. But you can see that some drawbacks also were there associated because with this industrialization. I told you that they gave much importance for industrialization. Okay, because they felt that industrialization will bring more economic development, and it will be helpful for the country to grow in a better manner. They felt like that, and what they did. As a part of that, they started producing, or you can see the industrial production, they want to make it very high. For that purpose, they started constructing the things in a very faster manner. Okay, in a very faster manner, in the sense, just 1 minute. Okay, so rapid construction was done in Russia. And because of that, what happened, the working conditions, it became very poor, because government's main aim is what now? Rapidly the country should develop. For that purpose, they need to set up a lot of industries, and this then only they can improve or they can develop. So as a part of that, rapid constructions were done all over Russia. Now, one example they have given in the city of Magnitogorsk, there they constructed a steel plant, and this was constructed in 3 years. That shows that so fast they constructed the steel plant. Usually it will take more than 5 years for a construction of a steel plant and all, 5 to 10 years like that. But here they finished the construction within 3 years. So you know that so many workers are needed for that. So many workers are needed. So many things are needed. Now what happened to the workers here? Workers' life became very hard, and it was very miserable, because you know that as fast if they, when they want to produce something, they make them to work more hours, more workers will be there. So when more workers are there, they are to be provided a lot of facilities there. So that was not given properly to the workers here. That is one thing. And the same time, you can see because of this miserable life, workers, we can see that 550 stoppages of work were there in the first year alone. 550 stoppages means what now? What do you mean by that?
They stopped working.
Yeah, they stopped working. And in a year, you know that how many days we have?
365.
Yes. And you see how many times they stopped working, that is 550. So that which miserable was the life of workers, because of that reason they stopped, they in between stopped the work and all. Or they are showing their protest against the government there or the construction. Another one, in living quarters in winter time, you can see that they never had the people, those who are living in the fourth floor and all, they didn't have toilet facilities in the area where they are living, in the floor where they are living. So here they have to come down and they have to, so you just see four floor, you have to come down and go up. It was very difficult for them. So like that, that this shows that facilities, proper facilities were not provided for the workers during that time. So they were unhappy with the system. Okay. Another one thing what they did, they extended the schooling system, in the sense of proper schooling system they have developed, especially sometimes, you know, that some didn't get the chance to go to school. So an extended system they introduced here. And even they made arrangements for the workers and the peasants to go to universities. Okay, that system, it was developed. Another one thing you can see, creche facility was developed. A creche facility was developed in the sense, you know, that sometimes there will be some women workers who have children. So those children needs to be taken care. So for that purpose, they introduced creche facilities and cheap public health care was provided. Cheap public health care means what now?
At low cost.
The price for the health facilities, it was very low. That government made it compulsory. Then only they can provide proper facilities to the people. So because of that reason, they made here. Another one, some living quarters they set up for workers. Living quarters they set up in the sense, some with proper facilities and all, but that was not, it was inadequate actually. Okay, because you know that many workers are there and these many workers have to be accommodated. So in some places, the living quarters were proper living quarters were constructed, but some of the areas, it was not at all adequate. Or we can say because their aim was what? More and more construction and all those things within few years. So they require a lot of workers for that. So according to the requirement, that many facilities they were not provided to the workers here. So many things they introduced. So if you take the condition of workers, what is the situation they have given, whether they were happy or how was their life, what situation they have given related to workers?
Hard lives.
Yeah, their lives, it was very hard. And what about the facilities?
Poor facilities.
Yeah, poor facilities for the workers there. But at the same time, they did many other facilities to the people. What are those facilities?
Ma'am, they extended schooling system.
Yes, they extended schooling system. Then?
Factory workers and peasants were allowed
to go to university so that they can learn. Then? Creche facility. Especially this creche facility is for what? Looking after the children of women workers. Okay. Another one thing what they introduced. Cheap public health care was provided. In the sense, public facilities were provided to the people at a very cheaper rates or at a very low cost. Another one, some living quarters they set up for the workers here. So these are the important points related to whatever they did. Bolsheviks, they did.
Last point.
Yes. So here you can see some of the pictures related to children. They are going to school in Soviet Russia. That is one thing. Another one, one child, he is in the particular city where they constructed the steel plant, that is Magnitogorsk. There, what is the situation? You can see that child is working. So for them also, they extended some schooling system for them. Then, like this, lot of facilities were provided to the people. Now factories, a lot of factories they set up in Russia. Another one picture, if you see factory dining hall, you see that so many workers will be there. Then only this dining hall is like this. So many, you see, so many tables and chairs are kept. It is only a part they have given. So you just imagine how many workers will be there in that particular industry where they have provided this dining facility. Now, next one is about Stalinism and collectivization. That is the next topic, Stalinism and collectivization. Now, what do you mean by Stalinism and collectivization? You know that who was the leader of Bolshevik Party? Who was the leader? One leader was there, right?
Lenin.
Yeah, Lenin. So after his death, we can see that another leader is coming, that is Stalin. And he introduced a lot of measures and a lot of policies. He changed and introduced a lot of changes in his in Russia, in his area. So that we call it as Stalinism. And his main idea is collectivization. Collectivization. I'll tell you what is this collectivization. Okay. Now, to start with, you can see here a lot of disasters we can see for this collectivization. Okay. Disasters for collectivization in the sense when we talk about collectivization, Stalin felt that all the land what the peasants were having, that should be collected. That should be pooled together, make it one, then there should be cultivation. Okay. For example, you know that if you see small plots are there nearby. Okay. These are small plots like this. Maybe one plot is like this. Various plots are there. So Stalin, what he felt that this should not be like small plots. He wants to collect all these plots together and make it one. So he doesn't want to. Here, how many plots I have done? How many plots?
Nine
plots are there. Okay. So what he wants, instead of these nine plots, he wants this to be?
One.
Okay, and he felt that then the production will be more. That is what he feels. Okay, because in the small plots, it is very difficult to use machines and all. Okay, so he doesn't want to waste that small. I mean, he wants to increase more and more production. For that purpose, he wants to introduce modern type of agriculture. So if the small plots are there, machines will not be able to apply more. He cannot do much, he felt. And he gave this idea of collectivization. Okay. Now, you know that the lands are in the hands of whom?
Peasants.
And why he introduced this collectivization, there was a reason for that, because there was a problem of food shortage. Grain supplies were very less. Okay, shortage of grains were there during that time. And that is one thing. Another one thing, government, I told that government fixed the prices for things. So government, what they did, they fixed the prices for the grains also. But the peasants, they were unhappy, because what happens if they sell at the prices what the government tells, they are not getting any profit. So peasants, they refused to sell the grains to the buyers at which is fixed by the government. Okay, so like this, a lot of problems we can see when the Bolsheviks, when they introduced changes in the administration. So here, once more, I told that they had a very good planned economy, but you can see that lot of problems have come because of this collectivization of agriculture. Okay. Now, why this has become a problem? Why Bolsheviks introduced the collectivization? There is reason for that. First reason, there was acute shortage of grains. Second, when the government fixed prices, what happened? Peasants, what happened to the peasants? What they did?
They
refused to sell the grain, which at the prices fixed by the government. Okay, so this is becoming a problem now. So that time only you can see that Stalin is coming to power. So after the death of Lenin, Stalin is coming, and he introduced some strict measures he introduced. Okay, now I told you before that all these lands, maybe it may be small or big, it was in the hands of peasants. Okay, now when we collect the lands, will the peasants have the ownership?
No.
So will they be happy?
No.
They will not be happy at all. So because of this reason, you can see that peasants are becoming angry now. Okay, we'll see that. So he is going to introduce some firm measures here, strict measures he is introducing. Okay, what he felt that these rich peasants, some are rich, some rich traders were there. What are they doing? Whenever the price is not that high, what do? For getting a higher profit, what they will do? They are rich people, so no need to sell the grains now. They have money with them. So those who are poor people only, you know that they want money itself, they'll sell it off. Okay, those who are rich peasants and traders,
they will store.
Yeah, they will store that and keep. Why do they keep like that?
Because they have more money now.
I know, expecting that in future,
if the shortage,
the price will increase, that time they will sell this. Okay, so if they are keeping like this, what will happen in the market?
Shortage.
There will be shortage, right? Because rich peasants and traders, they are not selling now. They are keeping it with them. They are withholding those things with them. So supply is less in the market now. When supply is less, what will happen?
Price will increase.
Yes, price will increase automatically. So these rich peasants, what happened now? They are not selling now, expecting that they will sell this at a higher price in the future. So that we call it as speculation. Okay, they are speculating now. They are guessing now. They are speculating that in future, the prices will increase. So that time they will supply this food grains in the market. So because of speculation, what happened? Now food grains are not available in the market. So naturally the prices will increase. So what Stalin felt that this speculation should be stopped. Okay, and supplies, whatever supplies are there with this rich farmers, that should be confiscated, because he understood that if more speculation is there like that, things will not be available in the market and prices will be go very, very higher. So what he felt that this speculation should be stopped, and the supplies in the sense that food grains, whatever they have kept as a stock, that should be confiscated. Okay, what do you mean by confiscated?
Seized.
Yeah, it should be seized or it should be taken from them. Okay, so that is one thing which he felt during that time. Now what happened, 1928, party members, what they did, party members means which party members?
Bolshevik.
Yes, Bolshevik, Communist Party members. They went for a tour. Tour in the sense they went for visiting the areas of grain production. Okay, so they are going to the areas where they are producing, and they started supervising the grain collection. Okay, how they are collecting the grains, whether they have collections or what, whether they have grains or what, they started supervising this. They started studying this. And they started raiding kulaks. Trading kulaks in the sense, this is a name which they use for well-to-do peasants. Well-to-do peasants means rich peasants. Okay. So what they did here? What did they do?
Private.
The party members.
Yes.
They toured the grain.
Yes. They toured the grain producing areas. Then?
Raiding.
Supervised. Supervised first. Okay. Then they supervised the grain collection. Then they started raiding the kulaks. And what do you mean by this kulaks?
Rich peasants. Rich.
Yes. Rich peasants. But still the shortages, it was continuing. Okay, shortages, it was going on continuing. Much grain production was, much grains are not supplied in the market. So what happened? The government or the party members, they felt that they should collectivize the farms. Okay, I told you, what do you mean by collectivization? All the small farms, it should be brought together and make it a big farm. And all these farms' owner will be government, not the peasants. Okay, so peasants, will they like that?
No,
never, because they are losing their ownership here. They are giving, they have to give this lands to whom now? To the government. Okay, so why they said the why, what is the reason they are telling for collectivization? What is the reason government is telling for collectivization?
Otherwise,
is that
shortage will be,
yeah, shortages are there. What reason they have given here? This shortage is mainly because of small size of holdings. Okay, as I told you that small size of land holdings, we cannot use much machines and all. So what they said, what they said to the people, what they started talking, that why the grain production is less? Because of this small size of land holdings. This they told, if they started telling this. Now after 1917, what happened? After 1917, what happened? The land, this is when, after 1917, when it is? During the, after the October Revolution. Okay, you know what happened. What happened to the land after 1917?
Given to the peasant.
Now, see, now, yeah, now we are talking about which year, 1931, 1928, 1929. Okay. Before. Yeah, we are talking about 1928. What was the situation in 1917? That was, land was being given to peasants. That's during fine. That time. Yeah, during that time after October Revolution, land, they told that lands can be confiscated by peasants. But what happened, because of the small sized farms, the peasants could not do any modernization in that. What do you mean by modernization?
Use modern methods.
Yeah, we use modern machines, modern method of cultivation, all those things they were not able to use. So what reason now they are telling? To develop these modern farms and to make them like industry, or like industry in the sense industrial production will be very high, and we need to use all the modern method of production, then only the production will be more. Okay, so to develop the modern farms and to be like industrial way, how to use the things in the farms, it is very much important that they should eliminate the kulaks. The kulaks in the sense that peasant system itself should be eliminated. Eliminated means what? Yeah, it should be abolished or it should be removed. That shows, that means what? We have to take the land away from the peasants, then establish state-controlled large farms. So you see the changes now. After the October Revolution, all the land, everything was distributed to the people. Now government feel that if this small farms are there, when they, where they are doing the cultivation, the production is not happening. Much production are not there. So what is their plan now?
Establish state control.
Yes, collectivization, establishment of farms into one. Okay, removal of kulaks. So peasants, they will be happy or what? Never. Because the ownership is going from them and it is going to whom? To the government or to the state. So they wanted to avoid now kulaks, or they wanted to take from the peasants, land from the peasants, and that they wanted to establish a state-controlled large farms. So this system they wanted to introduce, and slowly we can see that peasants are becoming angry towards that particular system. Okay, then, bye everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.